once we had two restaurants, things, oddly enough, got progressively easier. Then we had three. And it's gotten easier for me with every restaurant we've opened. Because once you don't have one restaurant, you're not the face of that restaurant. You don't have to do everything. You realize you can't do everything.
Yes.
And that is the rut you get into as a chef or a restaurateur. When you have one restaurant, you start off, and you always start off under the gun. It's always tough. It's tight. You know, the day you open, lots of customers come. But day two is always harder than day one. And then it's a grind to get enough customers to come back regularly. And so you take on this burden of doing all of the work yourself. And it's not sustainable. It's not healthy. You can't do a good job. But once you get a few more restaurants, you realize that you're not Superman. You can't do it all, and you just have to trust people. And once you do that, your life gets easy in the restaurant business.
I think that's the most difficult part for a lot of restaurateurs, is that they're not willing to delegate.
Exactly, but you got to remember, I'm 52 the hard way. So I didn't start out that way.
Right.
So I managed to cobble it together, keep it together for a long time.
Yeah.
And the last 15 years have been smooth sailing. Yeah. It's so. I got lucky, you know. I picked the right woman to help me out, and she got me to clean up my act. I got lucky. I mean, I came out better off than I started in this business, and that's unusual. You have to let your ego go and realize that you're not the only person that can do it.
Right.
And when you do realize that, everyone you work with is happier, because they take on more responsibility. They have more say and more stake, and everyone's happier. For me, That is the secret.
I think that's exactly what it is. It's the culture that you're able to build.
And we're not cooking ego driven food either, right? Mm-hmm. Our goal is not to make ourselves happy. It's to make our customers happy. We cook food that tastes good, and it's always going to taste good. I mean, it's pizza and pasta. Mm-hmm. How bad can it be? Mm-hmm. And there's a lot less pressure. You don't have to grind all your employees all the time.
Yeah.
You know, we have a lot more flexibility. The music's loud, covers up a lot of the flaws, and it doesn't have to be that hard. And this business, if it's going to have a long future, has to learn that we can't take all of our anger out on our employees and make it that difficult. We need to make their life easy as well, and that support does. I mean, when Nicole and I started 23 years ago, I mean, we both worked in restaurants forever, and we swore we would never run our restaurants the way we'd been treated for the previous 10 years of working in restaurants. So we try not to have long days for the cooks. We don't do split shifts. We try to keep a bit of a work-life balance as best we can in this business.
Yes.
And it's not always easy in the kitchen. It's very hard to hire people.
Oh, for sure.
So sometimes you really do have to rely on your kitchen staff to work more than they should work.
Mm-hmm.
But we do our best not to do that.